Let's go back to the browser and refresh, and you should see your qualities heading here. It's clear that it looks different than our image, so we have a few things to adjust. Now, if you've never worked with typography before inside of a web page, then there are several properties that will be new to you. And if you're starting from scratch, probably what you'd do is go to Google and do a search for text or font CSS properties. Let's see what happens if we do that. So I'm going to open up a new tab and I'll do a search for text or font CSS properties. So you can see a few options that appear from W3 Schools at the top. And if we clicked on this, you could go down this and learn a little bit more about some of the properties that we'd adjust. For example, you'd see right away that the font that we're using is a serif font. If we go back to our example here, you can see that there's little ledges on the edge of every letter. I'm going to zoom in a bit so we can see that up close. So on this U, you can see that it kind of has a lip. And down here at the bottom, the tail has a lip as well. So what we're dealing with is a font that has a serif. I'm going to go back over to the W3 Schools page. What we want, though, is a sans serif, which means without a serif. Because if we look at our example here, you don't see those ledges on any of the letters. If we go back to the CSS font page and scroll down, you'll see the first example talks about how to set the font family. And if we looked at the details, it would tell us that we can use a keyword like serif or sans serif, and then we can separate suggestions by commas. The thing is that when a font is used inside of a browser, that font has to be available on the client computer. It is possible to include a font with your web page for the user to download, but on the whole, it's better to avoid that if we can, because font files are actually rather large. And if we can avoid forcing the user to download that font file, then our page will load quicker. So what this line says is that we're setting the font family property. And this example is using a selector, which we'll get into shortly. But we can also use this inside of the style property in our heading tag. So we have the font family property, and then we're setting the value to a series of suggestions. The first is Times New Roman, which almost every computer has, so there's a pretty good chance that we'll be able to use that. But if the client computer, that is the computer where the browser is being used, doesn't have this font installed, then instead, let's try to use something in the Times family. So this might be Times New Roman or a number of other fonts that fall in that family. If none of those are available, then we want to use a serif font. And the client computer is almost guaranteed to have a serif font installed. So the reason why we would be more specific if we can is because we want to match what the user sees to the design as much as possible. And if they have the right font for it, then we're good to go. If they don't, though, we want to get close to the design. We at least want the spirit of the font that's being used to come through. And the reason we might use a serif font is because we want it to look a bit fancier or official. Font that doesn't have a serif looks more modern and casual. So for example, this page uses a sans serif font for almost everything. So let's go back to our example. And let's change the view to the actual size. And let's start by changing the font family here to sans serif. So we could go back into our code in our IDE and adjust it here inside of a style property. Or if we want some live feedback as we adjust our styles, we can do it right in Chrome. So if I right-click this element and select Inspect Element, then we'll be able to adjust the styles by changing them right here. So first what I'm going to do is click on this, and this is the element.style. So this is the style property of the H2 element that we're working with here. And when we click on it, it sets the cursor to the first property that we want to use. So let's set font family, and you can see that it auto-completes and we can hit tab in order to finish typing that out. You can see a list of options here. We're going to select sans serif. And then I'll hit tab in order to apply it. And you can see when we did that, it changed up here. Now instead of those little tails being added to the tops and bottoms of the letters, it's smooth.